The Grand Collapse of Humanity is the song that actually kick-started this project. It was just meant to be a single that manifested itself into an EP, which eventually turned into an album. So it was only fitting that this was the opening song on the album.
Sacrifice your cause for the human ideals. Accustom your life for the force of natural.
The story of how I got introduced to Kevin and how this song came together is quite interesting, because I'm quite active, or at least I was active on Facebook quite a bit, and I was part of a metal drumming Facebook group called Metal Drummer Nerds, and Kevin was a regular poster on that group. He was quite well known. I had seen a couple of his videos and I thought he was an amazing drummer. And I very specifically remember him uploading a cover of a Benighted song, which he very clearly mentioned was 270 BPM in the start and then later shifts to 250 BPM. I don't know what it was about that particular video, but just seeing 270 BPM and watching Kevin absolutely nail those blast beats at that tempo, it just blew my mind. And in Kevin's post, he had written, if you want me to drum on your album or your song, email me at this ID. And you know, I joked in the comments saying, hey Kevin, I'm going to hit you up. And the next thing I know, I'm on my computer writing an email to Kevin saying, hey, you know, I want to do a song at about 270 BPM. Do you think you'll be up for playing on it? And that's kind of how I got in touch with him. And Kevin wrote back saying, yeah, I'll be more than happy to play on your song. You know, just send me the scratch track. So I literally went to the studio, put on the metronome at 270 BPM and started writing this song. Musically, even though the song is at such a fast tempo, it's not just unrelenting blast beats throughout, you know. I mean, I've always loved playing fast, and in India, well, I've never really had the opportunity to play with drummers who play at that tempo, you know, 270 and above. So it was very exciting for me to be able to play, with a drummer with that capability to write without having a limitation, you know. Like in DR, we know that, you know, Viru can play a certain tempo, like up to 250 BPM he's able to play. But beyond that, it's not possible for him, you know. And it's the same thing with earlier drummers of DR. Everybody had a limitation on how fast they can play. So we've always written music keeping that in mind, you know, that okay, we cannot exceed this tempo because it's just not possible for them to play. And even with my previous solo album with George Kolias, despite George being able to play really fast, that album wasn't written keeping George's drumming in mind. That album was written as it was, and then it was handed over to George to kind of fit his drumming to it. So this opened up a whole new sort of dimension for me. And even though I started out writing the song with a very brutal riff, and you know, like the song evolved into a lot of different changes, a lot of different patterns. Even what Kevin sent me, like, you know, the starting of the song itself, after that crazy roll that Kevin plays, the first pattern you hear is this really crazy tom groove. Now I was thinking the moment, you know, the song will start, like Kevin will just blast away at 270, but the thing is, Kevin brought another sort of perspective to the song and he really added his flavor to it. So I think in the end, it, you know, turned out to be a well balanced track, even though it may have started out with me just being excited to write at 270 BPM. The lyrics and the overall lyrical structure on this entire album is unique for me. It's a little different from what I normally do. In Demonic Resurrection, whenever we've done stories and we've kind of tried to tell a story, we've generally started in a sort of chronological way, you know, where we start at the beginning of the story and you go through it chapter by chapter till the end of the album. This album is also a story, but instead of starting out at the beginning, we actually start out somewhere in the middle. So if I had to give you like a visual reference for this song, what it is about lyrically, just think of the Avengers movie. Think of that, I think it's the Battle of Manhattan, where the aliens are invading and the Avengers are fighting them off. I think that's when Loki is the bad guy. And the thing is, it's not so much the Avengers in this story. This story is kind of like about the human race versus the reptilian race who are from outer space. This particular track, the lyrics are right in the middle of that battle. It is sort of the aliens versus the humans, but the human beings are so caught up in their own nonsense that they're actually at war with themselves, which is kind of sort of similar to our world today, you know, where humans are constantly fighting amongst themselves, whether it's over religion or politics or whatever. And it's almost like even if we had an alien invasion, it would be hard to unite the world to fight it because we're so busy fighting amongst ourselves. And if you read the lyrics, it's kind of telling you not just the story visually, but it's also kind of got like a sort of philosophical message, so to speak, or whatever. It's trying to say a little bit more, you know, lines like the human mind is born with a clean slate, through books of religion we are taught to hate. And people know me as an atheist, so that's kind of my viewpoint. Like, nobody's born with any religious inclination. Nobody's born believing in a god. Nobody is born hating another person because of their religion, race, color, or anything. We are born as innocent and pure as possible. It is what we are fed over the years. We are indoctrinated into religions. We are made to hate other people for, and it's something we would have never naturally done, you know. So this song kind of encompasses all that, and as well, of course, the important part of the story. And from here on, we go to the next chapter in the story and follow it to the end.
We should have listened, and we should have let them free. We should have listened, and we should have let them free.
It's quite interesting how songs go through so many changes right from their sort of creation right up to the moment they are mixed and mastered. And you know, with this song there was a lot of sort of interesting changes, especially because I had not planned anything. So you know, we wrote the song with Kevin and I had this entire template to sing over, and there's a middle section, the big chord section, where I actually wanted a guitar solo, and I tried to get a couple of my guitar friends to do a guest spot, but a lot of them were busy and I was in a hurry to put it out. So what happened is I ended up doing vocals over that, and you know, I didn't really expect to sing clean on this album at all, but just the way the song turned out, this, it kind of just sort of demanded those vocals. Even though in this song, though, I've done more of a sort of harsh clean voice rather than a like my regular cleans. So it was interesting, and I really enjoy being able to experiment vocally, and I'm really happy with how it turned out in the end. Working with Kevin was an absolute pleasure. He is a thorough professional, and I remember sending him the scratch tracks, and he recorded a rough drum track, sent it back to me. I gave it a listen, I had some feedback for him, I sent it to him. We finalized the song, and the next thing you know, he sent me the final tracks and the video fully edited in like 2 days time. So he's a complete professional, and you know, if you ever get the chance to work with Kevin, I would totally recommend it. He is now playing with Benighted full-time, and I couldn't think of a better drummer for that band. So it was an absolute pleasure for me, and yeah, I would love to work with Kevin in the future as well. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like me to do more sort of track-by-track analysis of my album The Last Reptilian Warrior, leave me a comment below and I'll do the next song in my next video. And of course, if you like the video, give it the thumbs up, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and I will see you guys really soon. Cheers and stay demonic.